A lot of discussions about ID resolution becoming really something that's really in focus for many of us now. And I wanted to ask you about ensuring foundational ID resolution capabilities to cover digital and terrestrial linking. Give us your thoughts there, please.
Sure. I know right now the focus is primarily on first party data and leveraging that as much as you can in consumer experiences. I think the other thing that brands need to keep in mind during this time is around, you know, having a foundational identity linking capability that allows you to recognize somebody before they're necessarily a first party record for that particular brand. So before they become a customer, you know, recognizing that individual and then tying that record back into second party and third party data is going to become really important as third party cookies start to deprecate, and being able to get more traffic to your brand and more awareness of potential customers to your brand is going to become really important. So having a foundational partner that you're using for that identity resolution that allows you to then link out to various other second and third party data providers is going to become foundational for brands in the future.
For folks who aren't familiar, could you explain what you mean when you say foundational ID resolution?
Yeah, so we're talking about starting with the consumer first. So recognizing those consumers that have the attributes that, you know, that are really going to make good customers for the brands, and pushing those consumers into your brand awareness is something that's been happening with third-party cookies and third-party cookie exchanges and linkages over time. As that starts to deprecate, having a solid base and foundation of known consumers that you're working against, and being able to tie your first-party customers back into that known group of consumers as a base is going to become foundational. So there's, you know, brands out there like Merkle, where, you know, we have the foundational consumer population of the U.S. that's backing our ability to recognize, recognize traffic and experiences that brands see on their different channels and out into media and different retail networks that are going to become important tomorrow.
So could you explain about capturing zero party data?
Yeah, so another thing that's really going to become important as we go forward, and I know a lot of brands are working on today right now, is how do they capture more relevant zero party data? So how do they get consumers to give them information about their experiences, about the types of things that they're looking for, about the interest that they have in their products, and trading that basically for that information? So as privacy, compliance, and regulation really becomes, you know, locked down in the future from being able to get that data from other places, encouraging consumers to continue to give that information to brands is really where a lot of people are starting to put their focus and energy, because, you know, you really want to personalize and make those experiences most relevant for consumers. But in order to do that, you know, brands need that data back. And so, you know, giving an exchange of value for that data is something that a lot of brands are working on right now in order to keep, you know, that consumer profile, or, you know, understand how to make their products work for consumers and drive what consumers are looking for tomorrow is going to continue to be relevant as we move into this compliance era.
And Sandra, finally, I wanted to ask you about the ability to link and leverage second party and third party data. What's the importance? What are some strategies? What's some of your advice?
Yeah, so I think the advice really is around ensuring that you have a good base and you're capturing all of the relevant information that you have against a first party record, right? Making sure that you're manifesting that profile out as much as possible, getting, you know, email addresses, physical addresses, variations of names, all of those things that are really important in order to identify that individual out further. the digital IDs that come associated with that individual, their mobile identities. And I know those are going to become harder as we move through. And a lot of the different partners are locking those IDs down, but trying to ensure that you have a broad enough profile in order to connect that back into second parties and third parties. And really, it's going to become important to leverage to leverage different exchange groups that have those second party and third party connections in order to then, take advantage of your customer base and drive that asset out further into different media opportunities and into that landscape as the third party cookie deprecates.